Nice work, guys. All right, well, a bombshell document from Ambulance Victoria is shedding new light on a traffic incident involving Premier Daniel Andrews and a young cyclist 10 years ago. According to the document seen by the Herald Sun, the Premier's car struck the then 15-year-old cyclist at 40 to 60 kilometres per hour.
So that report contradicts Daniel Andrews' claim that his car was T-boned by a bike in 2013.
He struck the right-hand side of our car.
Yeah.
We didn't see him. He was not visible on the road or anything like that. You know, he then went over the car after having gone into the windscreen. It was a very nasty incident, one that you wouldn't wish on anybody.
Let's bring in 3AW's Heidi Murphy in Melbourne. Heidi, good morning to you. Who cares? It was 100 years ago.
It was quite a long time ago, Carl. Morning to you and morning, Sarah. But it does keep coming up. It came up, in fact, during the election campaign last year. Questions do keep being raised, and this is the first time we've seen this particular document from Ambulance Victoria, this witness statement essentially, from paramedics who were at the scene at the time. And the way they've described it and the way they've described the patient's injuries aren't necessarily consistent with the Premier and the Andrews family's long claims about it. Instead of being T-boned, the paramedics write that the teenage cyclist was struck, ended up on the bonnet, then onto the windscreen, and the injuries he suffered down the left side of his body seem to perhaps be more consistent with that version of events. The paramedics, this statement hasn't been seen for 10 years. Police have investigated, the police response has been investigated, so whether this actually goes anywhere further remains to be seen.
Mm. I mean, let's be honest, it won't, right, Heidi? Knowing the way things play out down there.
Probably not. There is the family, the cyclist Ryan Mullerman and his father are taking or considering some legal action for some further compensation. They received a payout from the TAC back at the time, but they are seeking some further compensation and so taking some legal action.
So I reckon Neil Mitchell's the best broadcaster in the country by a country mile. He's looked into his crystal ball, as only Neil Mitchell can, and says Dan Andrews will be gone in 6 months. Yay or nay?
A lot of people think he will go. I don't know. It depends, I guess. He's wanted to stick around, I think, for the COVID rebuild, to be the man that led us through all of that time and leads us into the future. Difficult to step back from a job where he believes himself to be so terribly important.
No. He is, though. I'm the only one who likes Dan Andrews.
You're in the whole state of Victoria.
Love you, Dan.
Well, a staggering Ambulance Victoria document sheds new light on Premier Dan Andrews' clash with a teenage cyclist, going completely against the Premier's claims he was T-boned. Wayne, this isn't a good look for the Premier.
Was Elvis present when all this happened? I mean, it's 15 years ago. There's an obsession with Dan
Andrews. This is a document, though,
Wayne.
Well,
yeah, I know
it's
a document, and it's 15 years old, and we've raked over it before. I'm sure Neil will have something to say about it. But look, the truth of it is, Dan Andrews is the subject of a pretty sustained campaign in the newspapers down there and other parts of the media, and this is just another example of it.
Really? I mean, it's a document that says he did something other than what he claims he happened.
Well, 15 years ago, I'm sure there was a police investigation. Yeah, it does matter. 15 years ago, and I'm sure there was a police investigation. There's an obsession in Victoria with smashing up Dan Andrews, and this is just another example of it.
Is that right, Neil?
Well, of course there is. But have a look at the last week. The Ombudsman's taken after him. IBAC's taken after him. There is a direct contradiction here. It's true. But it is 15 years ago, and who's to know what the truth is? But I'll make... Wayne Swan, I'll have a bet with you. If you win, I'll vote Green at the next election. If I win, you vote Liberal. How's that? Have a bet,
never.
Right?
Never. Never.
That's a good bet.
No?
No.
the bet is Dan Andrews will be gone within 6 months. He's too much of a diversion for Labor. He's a trouble magnet. He's gone. Come, let's have a bet, Wayne. You vote Liberal, I'll vote Green.
He's a fine Premier, and he'll serve for as long as he decides to serve, subject to the electorate. That's what he's been doing well.
Now,
notwithstanding the smash-ups, notwithstanding the smash-ups that happened to him in the media, including with your good self.
Wow.
We had the Ombudsman saying he was... okay. Where's the bet? You won't have it? You won't be...
I'm not a betting man.
I'm not a betting man, and I'm not voting Green or Liberal myself.
Dan's gone. Dan's gone. Middle 6 months. 6 months, Dan will be gone.
Neil's called it. Very bold. Wayne all right, knows. Let's wait and see what happens in 6 months, guys. Thanks so much for your time, Carl.
Gee, I love watching those guys. It's electric.